So here we are with the 2.3 beta. This has been around for, what, 3 or 4 days. There's already plenty of videos on YouTube about it. But, well, I haven't done one yet. So, I thought I might as well do one now, seeing as I have nothing else to do. And, well, I'll start by addressing all of you Elite Dangerous and Frontier Developments brown-nosing cunts, because I know you're watching. You can't resist it. You know full well that it's a video by me, therefore I'm going to say stuff that you hate. But you can't stop yourself. You're going to keep on watching, aren't you? None of you have worked out yet that I deliberately provoke you. And you walk into it every single time. And believe me, I'm going to be provoking you again with this one. You're going to hate a hell of a lot of what I have to say. So yeah, you may as well click the fucking thumbs down icon now. But you can tell that that really, you know, bothers me, that, because, I mean, I've been doing these videos for nigh on 2.5 years, and I've had fuck knows how many thumbs down on every single one, and I'm still doing them. So, you know. So, anyway, I wasn't going to bother with 2.3 at all, because I have no enthusiasm for any of the features that it's bringing in. Not least the multi-crew. But as far as the multi-crew goes, it's a good job I have no enthusiasm for it, because as of yet, it's not in it. So we are testing the 2.3 beta, the biggest and, you know, most frequently touted feature of which is the multi-crew, and currently it's not there. So why is this beta even going? I mean, I've said time and time again, and I maintain this is absolutely true. A beta, right, is not what we are doing here. A beta test is testing finished code that's ready for publication, and it's basically, you know, testing it out and making sure everything works. Not a single one of Elite Dangerous's betas have come under that description. In fact, what we are doing is doing Frontier Development's in-house testing for them. They don't bother doing any. They just put it together, say, well, that works, sort of. Right, we'll slap it out there and let the beta testers, you know, do it for us. And in some cases, they even expect people to pay for the privilege of doing so. This is one such one. You can buy access to the beta if you don't have it normally. I think that is going to be happening a lot more frequently, probably with every single beta now, because of course the problem is that initially beta access, beta testing access was limited only to people who were either early adopters or paid for it when it was available. The problem for Frontier Developments is a huge number of those people have since seen the direction the game's gone, and now they don't play it at all. They've either sold their accounts or they just don't bother loading it. They probably even haven't even got it installed. So consequently, Frontier Developments got next to fuck all in the way of feedback for some of their betas. So the only way they could actually start getting a reasonable amount is to put the beta for sale and make it available, you know, people to buy access for. So, that's what we got here. Well, like I say, this is the worst one yet. I mean, every beta that Frontier Developments have done for Elite Dangerous has progressively got worse and worse as it goes on. Until now we've got to this one, where you can say at the moment, the multi-crew features in the Elite Dangerous 2.3 beta are currently turned off while we investigate a related set of issues. It's the biggest feature of the 2.3 update, and it's the one that Frontier Developments themselves have been banging on about for months. And now the beta started, and he's not there. However, that is not necessarily a bad thing. Not when you look at how it's been implemented. I'll come to that in a bit. Now, among the other options, there's this new one here called Network. I'm not going to select it, because you would have to be a fucking brain-dead prick to select that in a video, because what it does is reveal your entire IPv4 and V6 information. And I've seen one video already where that person does that. So their IPv4 and IPv6 information is all there right in front of you for just anybody to fucking copy. Yeah, that's a smart move, that. Now, because I'm recording this in regular daylight, it looks like there's a hell of a lot of light streaming in through the window, so I'm going to close a couple of curtains. Not that I think anybody's particularly desperate to see me in all my glory, but, that's sort of... See, that's made fuck all difference, really, hasn't it? Oh, well. Anyway, let's get it started up then. I'll go into the private group. As you can see, I am in a new ship. That is the Dolphin. And I think it's a piece of shit. As is displayed by the name of the ship, because some 2 years after it was first, actually I think it's more than 2 years after it was first said by Frontier Developments that we would be able to do this, you can now finally name your ship. So my ship, as you can see just above or the top of the info panel, is called the Shit Heap. Now, in order to change your name, what you need to do is go into the outfitting, or you can go via the livery, and you see here ship name, shit heap, ship ID. You can just type in whatever you like. Now, something else you will notice here very quickly is that there is an awful lot of new slots made available. Weapon detailing, although what that is I don't know, because if you click it and then select browse, it's the weapon color. Well, I'm sure I've already got weapon color somewhere here. No, I haven't. Okay, so that's weapon detailing. There's nameplate 1 and 2, ship ID 1 and 2, but these empty, nothing there. Engine detailing, browse, nothing there. And that seems to be it. I thought there was more than that. So we have 1, 2, we have 5 new areas. Of course, all of those are going to be for new microtransactions, which is Frontier Developments trying to get more money out of their established player base. And of course the reason they're doing that is because that is the only way they are getting money from this game anymore. The game is not getting new players, it hasn't done for fuck knows how long. So the only way Frontier Developments can continue to make a profit on this thing is to constantly add more and more microtransactions and get existing players to spend more money on it. So that's where you're going to get, you know, different kinds of nameplates, these ship ID plates here, or whatever the fuck engine detailing is going to be. It's probably just going to be a different colour to your the thrusters. I can't see what else it can be. And then of course they will then add different versions of those to your, oh yeah, I haven't got anything else fitted, but to your SRV, then to your ship launch fighter. And also, why did I try and muffle that one? To the holo-me, which is the commander creator. Now, there we go. So what they will then do is doubtlessly add all kinds of like different helmet designs, different suit colours, different shoulder decals, and of course charge you for all of these as well. Now, I spent all of about 30 seconds on this, because basically all I did was change the helmet design to 01 and then select it so it's always on. If you've played any BioWare RPG, and I suspect the vast majority of Elite Dangerous players have played at least one BioWare RPG, probably one of the Mass Effect games, just so long as it's not Mass Effect 3, you're already very familiar with how this works. Except if you try and rotate your key, so you can't do it because none of the keys are all bound. And if you bind it to the left mouse button, you then can't select anything in amongst all this lot. So it's a total fucking bollocks up. So I can't even remember what my bloke looks like. Wrong one. It also has a lot of trouble saving anything. So there you go, that's what my my bloke's face. Let's see, let's take the helmet off. There you go. So actually, now I've seen that, yes, I remember. I did spend about a couple of minutes. That's supposed to be looking like me. As you can see, it looks fuck all like me, but there you go. And I just couldn't be bothered to work in it anymore. So, yeah, I kept the helmet on. So that way you don't have to bother with the face. So I can say, yeah, there you go, there's my commander who looks just like me. It's just that you can't see it. Oh dear, what a shame. So, that's the commander creator. Now, actually, before I go into that one, we'll go into the galaxy map. Now, I had to self-destruct when I started this, because I was fucking way out. And what I'll do is I'll try A871. So I was just, actually, I hadn't even got this far in the position I was in the beta. So what I'll do, yes. Now, if you are far away here and you're trying to, you know, check something out that's in the distance, because, and it has been highlighted by either a bookmark or something, you move the mouse over, it does not pick it up at all. Now this is one of those things where all of the brown-nosing fanboy cunts will say it's deliberate. That's a new feature. What purpose does that serve? It looks like a bug, it acts like a bug, or, well, not a bug, but a glitch, whatever you want to fucking call it, a complete fuck-up. So you can't say, for example, you know, if you're out in this distance here, say this is the system you are in, you can't then just quickly check how far away you've come. I don't know if that is intentional or not, but I can guarantee you that the brown-nosing fanboy cunts will say that it's intentional and it's a feature. They do it all the time whenever it's a glitch like this. So, and speaking of features, where the fucking hell, right. When you are setting your power priorities in the modules panel, there are a number of times yesterday, no, my luck, it won't do it now, where I was changing priorities, and when I moved it to either left or right to adjust the priority, it would suddenly highlight the next one down. There we go, like that. So, I mean, I actually did want the cargo hatch at 5, but I had power distributor selected. Power distributor has now moved down. Why is it moving up and down like that? It's so fucking disorientating. Now, again, I suspect that this is a fuck-up, a glitch, which means that the brown nosers will tell you it's a feature and it's deliberate. Bollocks, is it? Another thing is that in all of your ships now, under fire groups, under utilities, you will find data link scanner. Well, that's the thing that's in your SRV, isn't it? As far as I was aware, your ship doesn't have one. Except it seems as though it now does, but it doesn't appear anywhere in the modules. No, it does. There it is, it's at the bottom. Well, it doesn't appear when you are outfitting the ship, so presumably you can't remove it. So, what's it for? Why does your ship need it? What are you scanning? Does it appear? Does it appear on here? Yeah. So I've no idea what it's there for. Your guess is as good as mine. Now, one thing I don't like is that this holo-me option now appears down here along with view engineers. So if you want to be able to scroll down through your stats, you have to push up from view engineer to holo me, then up again, and then start scrolling down. And now, if you are, say, halfway through your stats, if you want to view the holo me or view engineers from this page, you've got to either scroll all the way up again or all the way down again. And it's actually, it still hasn't appeared, so you have to scroll all the way down. For the highlight to actually appear on these options. That is a fucking pain in the arse. It's going well, isn't it, so far? Right, now there is the change to the comms panel. There's an extra tab, this one, the Multicrew tab. It's actually the Friends tab, but it's now had the Multicrew thing added to it as well. So that is where you would then set up the Multicrew thing. I'll come back to that in just a second. But when you have this one highlighted, for some reason you can't go onto the next option straight away. So push it, does nothing, push it again, you have to keep pressing it twice. Why? What purpose does that serve? Everything else, push it once. Get here, push it, nothing. Push it again, then it will change. We'll go back, push it once, nothing, push it again. Why? The other thing is that new... Just type in a message so you can see what the display now looks like. Fuck off, you cunt. It's a P appearing like a fucking local one. I want it to be... I don't want it to go local. Unless they fucking changed it, which, no, either way. Let's come out of here and go up and get some messages appearing up here. You will see that it has, they've changed how it looks. Changed it very much for the worse. It now looks something like the display from an original Game Boy some 20 odd years ago. Since I'm up here, I may as well show you the Dolphin. Oh, I wanted to show the fucking loadout, that means I've got to go back down. I'll tell you what, we'll show you how the Dolphin handles. No one seems to be saying anything. Normally there is plenty of dialogue going on. But of course now that I need it to illustrate the point I'm trying to make, it's not going to fucking show up. Now I am absolutely hopeless at flying the smaller, more agile ships like this one. So I fly this ship like a fucking Muppet. Now I've had a scan, hopefully that means he will now send me a message. There you go. Now it's got that horrible sort of like yellowish green LCD display behind it. Why is it done like that? It looks fucking horrible. And amazingly, even some of the brown noses are saying it looks fucking horrible. On the display, on the display, what am I fucking talking about? On the, on there, the forum. I think I was right first time. But yeah, on the forums, I haven't seen a single person say, yeah, it looks good. No one seems to like it. But of course, we're talking about Frontier Developments here. Unless some, you know, unless fucking Obsidian Ant and that fucking cuntish lot actually complain about it, then Frontier Developments don't do anything. I refuse to believe that Obsidian Ant is not on the Elite Dangerous payroll. They only listen to his complaints, no one else's. No matter how constructive the criticism is, they don't want to know. As soon as he says something needs changing, they will do it. The other thing is that you know, he gets far more fucking attention on the in newsletters, on the actual loader news. He's even had, you know, a fucking docking station, a quite major one named after him with a faction, all for nothing. Now don't tell me it's just because he's a fan. That's just bollocks. So I am convinced that he is on the Frontier Developments payroll. I don't care, you know, if that's wrong, that's just what it looks like to me. So anyway, let's go in the hangar then, I'll show you the loadout of the Dolphin. Now like the Beluga, it does have a it does have one of those annoying slots where you are limited in what you can actually fit in it. So right, hard points are pathetic. You got two small hard points and that's it. I mean, it is only a small ship, so I suppose it's to be expected. You're not going to have a great deal that you can fit to it. So I've got an A-rated shield booster, point defense and chaff launcher in the utilities. In the core internals, again, nothing particularly impressive. You can have a class 4 power plant, class 5 thrusters, class 4 frame shift drive, although its range isn't terrible for a ship that only has a class 4 FSD. Class 4 life support, class 3 power distributor, which tells me that it's not a good idea to use this ship in combat. Well, as if the, you know, two small weapons didn't tell you that already, and class 3 sensors, so everything is very mediocre. Now with the optional internals, you do have a class 5 slot, but this is the limited one. So you can only fit cargo racks, hull reinforcement, module reinforcement and passenger cabins. That's it, nothing else. Everything else in it, I think you can fit whatever you like. So I've got A4 fuel scoop, A4 shield generator. I don't think this is a limited one. No, it's not. But I fitted a cargo rack to it anyway. I don't think this one's limited either. No. So it is only that one. But of course it's the class 5 one, the most useful one. And yeah, the detailed surface scanner and the advanced discovery scanner, and that's all I put on there. Just to quickly add, there's a new engineer mod. I can't remember if it's the detailed surface scanner or the advanced discovery scanner, but you can mod either one. I have no idea what the mods are, but I think one of them, what's the name, Jameson, who is in Shinrata, is one of the engineers who will do it. So, well, after we've done all this, I suppose we might as well head there and see what it's all about. Now, annoyingly, the Dolphin is the only new ship, and there are no new like upgrades for the outfitting. The Dolphin is quite low down, as you would imagine, in the sales list. It is now the cheapest ship that will cost you over $1 million, I think. Oh no, Type 6. Looks like they've dropped the price of the Type 6. Oh no, that's because I'm at fucking Shinrata, isn't it? Okay, so it's the second cheapest 1 million plus ship. So to buy it from Shinrata will cost you 1,173,000. That's fuck all, but to be honest, the ship is fuck all. I can see this replacing the Killback as being the most unpopular ship in the game. Because, well, by now, people have amassed a monumental amount of credits. If they really do want a ship for transporting passengers, they can get something better than this. Now this is another ship which was originally announced 18 months ago. It was announced at exactly the same time as the Beluga, and only now is it appearing in the game, but it's far too late. Like I say, there are no new players coming to the game, so what's the fucking point of this being in here now? No one's going to be interested. I mean, people are going to be flying it, you know, like me here in the beta, purely for the novelty of testing out what this new ship's like. But when the actual game comes along, it's fucking pointless. Now, one of the things that was pointed out was going to be new in 2.3 is extremely large ships. Now I've seen them constantly referred to as mega ships. I dearly hope that is not how they are actually called, because that is such a wanky fucking phrase. But for the moment, I guess I'm going to have to stick to calling them that. But when you go through here, it's all the same large ships. And that's because I completely misinterpreted the info regarding these mega ships. I thought it meant that ships like the Panther Clipper were finally coming into the game. Wrong. In fact, what these mega ships are, are enormous fucking great vessels which are as big, if not bigger, than a Celis docking station, or even the kind, yeah, even the Orbis stations. which are flying through systems which you can dock on, but you basically treat them like moving docking stations, and that's all they are, which pissed me off. It means you can't even fly them. The only thing that gives me sort of a small degree of optimism is that they could be the first stage of implementing a solution to providing a docking bay or a landing bay, whatever you want to call it, for the like really large playable ships coming, like the Panther Clipper. Because the problem with them at the moment is that they're too big to fit in any docking station. Now, originally it was rumoured that they were going to be docking in, or could only land on planets. I hated that idea. I find, you know, if you, all you can do is land on planets, that is a bit limiting. So thankfully it looks like that may not be the case, if this is right. I say those mega ships are fucking enormous. If I do another one of these videos for 2.3 beta, which is unlikely, but if I do, and hopefully I'll get the chance to show you what it looks like. If I can't, then there's already fucking million and one videos on YouTube of them. So, let's address the elephant in the room then, shall we, eh? The missing multi-crew feature. Well, we go into the info here, and it tells you all about it. Multi-crew. Multi-crew allows you to invite commanders onto your ship to act as crew, or to join their ship as a crew member. Your current ship does not support multi-crew. That's a shame. Mind you, nobody's ship does at the moment. So, benefits, better rewards, greater teamwork, instant access, additional pip for the power distributor. This is proving to be an extremely sore point for a lot of people. And the prerequisites, you must have a multi-crew capable ship. Clearly this is aimed at fucking morons, you know, they want multi-crew and yet they have to be told that they have to have a multi-crew capable ship. So, supported ships include, and then it lists a whole hell of a load of them. In fact, it should say these are the supported ships. It's not just that, you know, by saying supported ships include, it's suggesting that there are others among them. In fact, it lists every single fucking one that has the feature. Now at the moment, some of you may be thinking, yeah, that sounds fine, that's exactly what we were promised. It doesn't last. Let me just quickly show you something before I go back there. In the outfitting, not the outfitting, the shipyard even. If you check out, they've taken them off. Oh no, it hasn't. I'm just looking in the wrong fucking place. Right. I'm fucking up big time in this fucking video, aren't I? Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. Sorry, we have this stat here. Multi-crew ship. Two additional multi-crew seats. So that's two along with you. It's three. But people are probably thinking, hang on, we were told there would be four or more. No, it's three. Two is the absolute maximum multi-crew seats, or additional seats there are. So of course all the usual suspects have them, the big three plus the Beluga, the Type 9. The Python only has one, Further Lance only has one, Orca has one, Federal Gunship has one. In fact, they now all only have one unless you get to ships that cannot do it at all. Type 7 can't. And once you get to, once you get to the Keelback, the only ships now that can are the Cobras, you know, the Mark IV and the III, and the Adder. Now the Cobra Mark III, and the Adder, there you go. So yeah, it's not four or more, it's only three. Right, so here are your options then. You have the helm. The helm is the core control of the ship. This is always the commander who owns the ship. So if you're inviting people to do multi-crew, you are in the helm, and that you cannot do anything else. You can't say, right, I'm going to the take over the blah blah blah, someone else take the helm. No, you can't do that. If it's your ship, you're at the helm. You retain control of fixed and gimbaled weapons if there is a gunner in your crew. So, well, I'll come back to it in a minute. So the benefits are maintain core control. Well, you've got that to begin with. So how can it be a benefit that you maintain the ability that you had if you were, you know, flying or playing the game solo anyway? And reduced rebuy cost. I've got over a billion, and so have a hell of a lot of other players. Reduced rebuy cost is not an issue. So then you go on to the gunner. The gunner on a crew controls the turrets, missiles and torpedoes on a ship. They also control a variety of scanners, as well as the various utilities. And that is all they do. So if you've got, say, fixed weapons or gimbaled weapons, your gunner is sitting there doing nothing. Except using, if you have scanners or utilities, then he can sit there and use those. And that's all he can do. You have to have turrets, but he doesn't take control of one turret. He takes control of all of them. So he will aim those, and he will also fire your missiles or your torpedoes, which basically consists of sitting there pressing a fucking mouse button. But that is all he does. Now the benefits, additional pip for power management. So now you get two additional pips for power management, which means you could be flying around with four pips in engines, four pips in weapons rather, and four pips in systems. So your shields are at their strongest. How long is it going to be before the brown noses who have multiple accounts find a way to take advantage of this? Not very long at all, I suspect. Because all they have to do is outfit a ship with just gimbaled weapons or fixed weapons. Don't bother with any scanners. Just pile on the shield boosters rather than you know, using things like chaff and heat, point defense. Well, it doesn't say that the gunner can use a point defense, so I'm assuming he can't. And, you know, then just stick your second account in the gunner position, and there you go, you've got two extra pips. So anyway, the other benefits, enhanced targeting and the fire control system. That basically means that your gunner now aims your turrets. You better hope he aims well. But that's all he does. Everything else, I say, missiles, torpedoes, your scanners, your utilities, that consists of just sitting there pushing a mouse button, and that's it. External targeting view, well, that's the new camera. I don't give a toss about the camera. It's actually, I mean, to be honest, I don't give a toss about any of the new features in this, but still. There are already videos about the external camera. You've seen from my videos already that I barely use the external camera. That's not going to change, so I'm not going to bother showing the external camera. If you want to see about that, there are videos showing it. Quick fire slots for utilities, because pressing a key that you've got your utility bound to, that's too much effort. And improved turret rotation speeds. Well, they fucking need to be if somebody's controlling them. So, it's not looking too good as far as I'm concerned. Your first position is the helm, so you're flying the ship, and that's pretty much all you can do if you've fitted loads of turrets so that, you know, the gunner can actually do something. If you've got fixed or gimbaled weapons, then it's basically you're playing the game as normal. The gunner is sitting there, the other person flying around, and basically they're just occasionally pressing the fire buttons every now and then, and that's all they're doing. They're controlling either every weapon or none at all. But there's a third multi-crew slot, remember? Because of course you're in the helm. The first multi-crew slot is the gunner. So what does the third one do? He doesn't get a seat on the ship. The third one flies the fighter, the launched fighter from your ship. So firstly, you have to have the fighter bay installed. Secondly, just about everybody has come to the conclusion that ship launch fighters are fucking useless, because it means that you're flying a ship that is so fucking pointless, you may as well fucking try and dump a load of cargo bloody canisters on the enemy ship for all the good it does. But this is what the third multi-crew member does. He flies your ship launch fighter. But it does say that there is a benefit that ships with two fighter bays can send a hired pilot in addition to the commander piloted one. So in other words, if you have two fighter bays, you can use the first fighter in exactly the same normal way as you could any other time, and yet now suddenly it's become a benefit. But the second one can actually be piloted by a commander. That's great. So you can imagine that, you know, you've got two of you sitting there in like an Anaconda or a Corvette or an Imperial Cutter, and it's a case of, right, we're in this really big powerful ship. You, third crew member, you fuck off in the fighter, and good luck to you. We're in the middle of a high intensity conflict zone. There are Anacondas, elite Anacondas and elite Federal Corvettes all around us. Get out there in your fucking Taipan. Oh, fuck it all. And that's it. That is the implementation of multi-crew. So you look at that and you think, I'm fucking glad he's not in here yet. And that's, you know, I can't believe that that is not the opinion of people who want multi-crew. I'll say, I could not give a toss about multi-crew. I am almost certainly never going to use it. So the fact that I'm not going to use it means when I see those things there, I think, I am fucking glad I had no interest in it at all, because that is shit. Right, well, tell you, let's go to Jameson Base and see what these mods are for the I don't know if it's the detailed surface scanner or the advanced discovery scanner, but I know it's one of them. It could even be both of them, but I know one of them certainly can be modded now.
Landing coupler disengaged. Departure authorized.
I do quite like the engine sound of the Dolphin, but that's about the only thing I can say I like about it. I don't quite fancy the prospect of going outside and fucking knifing those cunts on the motorcycles out there.
Frameshift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Hardly any tea left. I was not exactly enthusiastic about this beta in the first place, and I'm less enthusiastic about it now than ever before, and it just seems to drop with every moment I'm in it. But I mean, going through that multi-crew layout, I couldn't give a shit when it's fucking added. It's not gonna make me wanna fucking try it. I'd rather do that. Well, I do that quite often in my vids, but there you go. So at the moment, I have this feeling that this could be the last time I play this 2.3 beta. It's not that it's shit. Well, it's not completely that it's nothing but shit. It's just that everything in it is fucking pointless. What does any of this add? It also shows that Frontier Developments themselves are practically admitting that they're not going to get any new players, because everything that's being introduced is pretty much just giving stuff to to the existing players just to give them something different to do. Nothing here is going to encourage new players to come along. I mean, why the fuck would they want to? If they haven't bought the game now after, 2 years and 3 months, however it's been out. If they haven't bought it now, they're not going to. Hey, what's going to happen when you got like your three players together? It's going to be like, right, who draws the virtual short straw? We're going to stay in the Anaconda, you get off and you fuck off out in your pissant fucking Condor. I mean, even players who like playing the game and piloting the small ships, and I know there are plenty, I mean, even they draw the line somewhere. You're not going to choose a fucking Condor to go into a fucking conflict zone.
Sound Kruger, Lima, Uniform, Kilo, Flight Control, online. Welcome, Commander. Request docking permission if you wish to land.
Docking permission granted. Where? I can't see. Oh, there it is. find that fucking great tower. And I'm coming in the wrong way. Now, I don't know if this is the only new mod, you know, there may be others, but it's the only one I've heard of. God, I am so fucking... Oops. I'm sure I...
Warning. Landing gear not deployed.
I did put the landing gear down and then I retracted it again.
Landing gear deployed.
I told you I'm not used to these fucking small ships. That was a nice smooth landing, wasn't it? Mwah.
Landing operation complete. Commence system shutdown. Welcome, Commander.
Surface scanners. So it is just the detailed surface scanner. So what do we have? Well, this first one tells me nothing, so I can have grade 5 of fuck all. This blueprint has extremely positive side effects. It doesn't tell us what the actual main effects are, let alone the fucking side effects. Scan range multiplier, so it increases the scan range. Why do you need that with a wide angle, scan angle multiplier? Okay, so that's the... So it looks like it's working in the same way that the... what do you call it? The frameshift interdictor is works. You can have one that, yeah, increases the multiplier. Or, I guess, increases the scan range, but... So that's how far away from the planet you have to be before you can scan it. And then fast scan, so... having it scanning faster is handy, but... that power draw doesn't look too fucking healthy. 100% mass goes up 200%, but then the mass of the thing isn't exactly huge to begin with. I can't remember what the power draw is on them. So there's one way to find out. That's fucking useful, that. So, well, all I can tell there then is that it uses 0%. Well, let's go in our hangar and have a look. Right, so the mass is only 1.3, power draw is 0.6, so, well, the power draw can at worst be trebled, so that will bring it up to 1.8, and the same with the mass, at worst that can be trebled, so that brings it up to 3.9, that's actually fuck all, that's okay. Power draw won't be so good trebled, but yeah, the mass is perfectly fine. But the more I think about it, even power draw trebled 1.8, that's not terrible. So, yeah, they might be useful if you are, you know, if you still have some discovering to do. I think that might be about it. Fuck it, let's go back to Jameson then and...
Landing gear retracted.
Take off, please.
1. Engage.
Online now. Well, either nobody else, either Ankelime or T. Howard, either they haven't bothered with their holo-me either, or it's not showing their designs. It also keeps saying that they're in the main menu. I can't imagine that both of those people are just sitting there in the main menu, so it looks like another fuck up, which means that the brown nosing cunts will tell you it's another feature. So you can ask them what the benefit is of a feature that tells people that you know, everybody else is all still in the main menu. I mean, you're not going to take a ship with two other fucking, you know, multi-crew members somewhere where they're not needed. So you're going to need them in... Okay. At this rate, I'm going to fucking crash into the fucking docking station. I mean, so you've got to take them somewhere where they're going to be useful and where they will actually get to do something. So you've got to take them somewhere like a high intensity conflict zone. But you need to have a ship that's going to last there. So you're going to have to take them to somewhere like you've got to go there in something like, yeah, like an Anaconda, Corvette, Cutter, you know, whatever, you name it. But it's got to be one of the, you know, the big powerful bastard things. In which case, you're flying around, if you've got, you know, gimbaled weapons, you use them. So, your gunner is sitting there just watching the screen, thinking, when do I get when do I get to launch me chaff? And then, meanwhile, you're looking through the fucking list of enemy ships out there, and you see, right, there's there's three federal corvettes, all with elite pilots. There's also, you know, two elite anacondas. Right, jump in your condor, off you go, sort them out. Oh, doesn't anyone at Frontier Developments possess an ounce of fucking common sense? Didn't any of them sit there and think, you know what, this multi-crew feature, I don't think it's going to work. Oh, fuck it. There you go, that's a 2.3 beta. Isn't that well worth waiting for? That'll do. I don't think I'd take this fucking seriously anymore, but I know I can't, so go away.